In my classroom, students can expect to not have to write long essays about what it is they love about games. Every single thing that we do in that classroom has a profound and meaningful impact to your future, your career as a game developer. Whether it be looking at the intricate skills of design, looking at how we balance our games, looking at the math that goes on behind the scenes, tricks to increase the performance of our games. The whole four-year program is really built around the idea of trying to take 10 years of knowledge and experience that we've accumulated and compressing it into a four-year period so that you come out industry ready. 50 times
the cost. Our lab is a state-of-the-art facility. This is a different classroom setup than a traditional design classroom or a traditional computer science classroom. It's set up so that students can work together in groups. Students will get a really well-rounded background in game design and development. Students are getting quite a bit of programming and quite a bit of art and design. So any student, when they graduate, will be able to choose their concentration for their capstone project and develop a portfolio based on what area of game design and development they're interested in going into.
I've recently found a love for storytelling, and I feel like my creations I can express and turn them into actual things by making role-playing games. It's also helping us build a lot of teamwork together. We've had to group think, we've had to come together and share our ideas. There are so many different parts of the game design team. It's really helpful for like constructive criticism because everyone on the team wants to be as successful as they can possibly be.
There's five kinds of students that are interested in our program. The first is an ambitious programmer. This is somebody that wants to find themselves a job in the industry working directly on game development. The second is an artist or animator, somebody that wants to play a supporting role in the games industry by building assets. These are our modelers, our riggers, our animators, our sprite artists. The third is game journalists, people that are interested in games marketing, people are interested in public relations. The fourth is my favorite, and that is the entrepreneur. This is a student who wants to see their own vision for a game realized from cradle to grave. This is somebody that wants to learn all the skills of game development as a generalist. And the fifth is a wild card, people who are interested in what is the largest and fastest growing entertainment industry in the world. Games are a monolith in society today, and no matter what you feel about them, people are wondering, what can I learn about this? How do I find my niche in the industry? And what can you teach us?